Bowman, it's Nomad. Send traffic.
The Bodarks control the Aurora data farm because, of course, they do. Your objective is to take it back without damaging it. Apart from being an eyesore, it contains all data on island-wide scale tech, the closest thing Aurora has to a federal reserve. Predictably, Edo is eager to preserve it. When it comes time to negotiate with other countries, the Outcast can use that data as a bargaining chip. It's up to you to capture the building and give the Outcast the green light to conquer the region.
I'll do a recon. These civilians were brutally executed. Some are still missing.
Damn it! The Bodarks will have taken hostages to oversee maintenance of the data farm. If you free them, the Outcasts could redirect their troops to help you.
The Bodarks sabotage the water cooling system. They'll destroy the data farm.
And they want to blow the backup servers nearby too. Before securing the data farm itself, neutralize the Bodark officers in charge of sabotaging the backup servers and the water cooling systems so they don't succeed.
Drones. This will be tough.
If you destroy the delivery VHCs before you attack the data farm, there will be less drones to protect it.
Helicopter. Bodarks around. They'll be quick to respond here.
It'd be a good idea to prevent reinforcements from acting, so you should destroy the choppers they'd use to reach the data farm. Kill those Bodarks. One less cold-blooded killer. It's the only way to prevent them from sabotaging the water cooling system and keep them away from the backup servers.
Belongs to the outcast now.
Bowman, Ito, it's Nomad. Mission accomplished. The data farm is ready for the outcasts. Bowman, this is Nomad. Send traffic.
The Bodark's Azrael fleet is a big issue for the outcasts. As long as they have it, the Bodark's can detect all movement in the province, and the outcasts will suffer heavy casualties. You need to take those drones down. There's an Azrael launch base for the main fleet and a production facility nearby. A thorough recon will help you plan your approach.
Fuck ton of Bodarks here.
Maybe you could cause a diversion to redirect some of them elsewhere. Assassinating officers in other locations could work.
An Azrael?
Before attacking the Arrow, you should destroy the Azraels in the production facility.
Lots of drones in the air.
Secure the Omega operation camp. Hand over any weapons the outcast can use to track and destroy airborne drones in the region.
All your drones are patrolling here.
There's a ton of them in the region. If you destroy the drone shipment VHCs, it should take care of them.
another victim of the drone swarm.
You should be able to infiltrate the buildings that operate the swarm. Depriving the Bodarks of the Azrael's is the utmost priority. Once you accomplish some destabilization missions, destroy the Azrael's in the production facility, and then destroy the main fleet at the launch base.
Copy. Out.
Get down, soldiers! We got company!
Target this truck. Over drone presence in the region.
Break! Fire at will!
One less cold-blooded killer.
Watch your sector! Come on!
Now the Outcast can track and destroy all the drones in the region.
They got one of us!
Here's one of the Bodark officers. Killing him might cause the diversion I need to lure troops away from the base.
Moving to contact!
Target down.
Down.
two s'more. Now I gotta destroy the fleet at the launch base. Damn, the Azrael's have bombs. They'll target civilian objectives. I have to act fast. Before launch. Close. I just need to hack the security system. Thank you. Bodarsh just lost her eyes in the sky. Civilians won't have to worry about Azrael's now. Bowman, Ito, this is Nomad. The Azrael fleet is grounded for good. Island skies are clear.
That's welcome news. It would have been a boon for the Outcast to be able to control the fleet ourselves, but I'm happy that no one can use it against us. Anyway, now we own the region.
The Azraels were equipped with explosives, set to detonate on random civilian sites. Their strategy made no sense.
The fuckers have no standards. They committed many random strikes. The only thing that strings them all together is that they were always caught on camera.
Won't make sense until we uncover their motivations for this deranged reality TV show. Once we do, I'm sure everything will fall into place.
Copy. Nomad out.
Nomad, all the intel you gathered paints a grim picture. Mass executions. Azrael's equipped with bombs. Jeremy Park's stage accusation of Russia. And warrant officer Vasily Kropotkin's involvement. Kropotkin is compiling recordings to upload onto the internet to attract attention. He's targeting Russia by feeding disinformation to the world to disrupt global diplomacy and ignite a major crisis. Most importantly, the data farm investigation revealed that Kropotkin has set up some kind of fortified film studio to broadcast his documentaries. You need to infiltrate it and neutralize Kropotkin before he starts something we can't fix. Prevent the broadcast and destroy those videos.
Copy. Assumes we'll never see the light of day. Out.
Okay, kill the broadcast. Nothing's been aired. This Kropotkin bastard really seemed pleased with himself. Kropotkin's dead. We won't have to worry about his lies anymore. I should search his body. An audio recording could be useful. Bowman's nomad. The broadcast hadn't started yet, and now it never will. I neutralized Kropotkin.
Well, it's a good thing you stopped his plan. It's a bit sad we can't interrogate him, lucky bastard.
I know. On the bright side, I found an audio recording on his body.
Play it.
Kropotkin, we need you to broadcast your activities once we complete our mission. Public pressure should force the U.S. and their friends to launch a disorganized attack on Sentinel and the Wolves, giving the Bodarks enough time to disappear. An open conflict will lead to destruction of our own resources, along with proof of our involvement.
The last thing we need is pressure on the U.S. and its allies to intervene on Aroa. Or to radicalize Russia further. This seems typical for SVR. Stealing secrets and leaving chaos in their wake. The Wolves are just cannon fodder for them. This could be a sign of an SVR false flag operation. Or a hint to something more nefarious, involving an organization that won't hesitate to incriminate Sentinel and the Wolves in service of a larger plan. The destruction of Aroa will prevent anyone else from using Skelltech.
Copy. Nomad out.
Defeated yet, Ito. Their HQ is on Golem Island. All the audio recordings trace back there. If the Bodark leader escapes with the stolen tech, Aroa will be ground zero for the next world war.
Oh, I won't let the Bodark leader leave the island. The Aroan people deserve peace.
I doubt the outcasts will be able to reach Golem quickly. They have the rest of Aroa to account for. And if that wasn't complicated enough, a drone swarm is blocking their entry into the island.
I'll handle this my way.
I'll send you all the intel on Golem Island, the bivouac RV point, and topography. It's the final hour, Nomad. We're all counting on you.